Okay.
I get stopped from the old lady all the time. I'm so lucky.
It's wonderful having a trustworthy, awesome partner in your life. It's necessary for success, I believe. Watching these guys mine nephrite jade. Vast deposits in Alaska. These areas, the geological areas where the serpentine green bedrock was put under pressure and crushed into jade. And I see the fever. Just like the gold fever. Which was the reason I quit. You know what? They make you move rocks in prison as punishment. That's what gold mining is. Either way, placer, no matter what, you're moving material, okay? And if it was easy, everyone would be doing it. The thing is that people get the fever anyway. These people might work 2 years before they find a big giant stone that pays all the bills. Can you imagine living under that pressure for 2 years of finding nothing in order to gamble? And because then now they have to bring on partners and shit like that. I recognize the fever, the gold fever. I had friends who quit their jobs, bought a bunch of mining gear, and were going to go and get rich because they were going to work harder. They were going to be smarter. They were going to be, and it's like a gambling fever almost. If you pick an area, there's many types of mining, minerals of all types, including gravel that you can file claims for. Gold, platinum, silver, these kinds of metals, they've been researched, targeted, and attacked, pretty well. The thing is, some mines that were not profitable when gold was $250 an ounce are now profitable now that it's $2,000 an ounce. So a lot of these old hard rock mines are opening back up. Better recovery methods, but it's still not easy. So it's a sport, it's a hobby, or it's a lifestyle. Otherwise, it's big business. Backhoes, trucks, gigantic diesel fuel bills, etc., etc., etc. There's not many middle ground operations. You either have heavy equipment or you have a dredge that you run around and access of various areas. It's never easy. Gas never gets any lighter. The walk to the dredge never gets any shorter. Being underwater 6 hours a day, okay? I mean, if you're not comfortable being underwater, then, you're going to have to be a metal detector or hard rock miner or working dry material. It's all work. It's all effort. There is no place where you can go and just pick up $100 bills, okay? Doesn't work that way. So I see the fever with these guys because, see, they own this jade claim. They own it. Now they have to just go out and find the quality they need on the property, which for me is better than gold because this is more a matter of auspicious luck, finding the rock. And it only takes one to make you a millionaire. So that's kind of, I can see the allure. I can see the just like gold fever, they have jade fever too. Yeah. I stopped taking people to go get, to learn about their gold recovery because especially if you go out, you work for 4 hours, you find a half ounce of gold, because you had a good day, and all of a sudden these guys are making all these calculations in their head, and they think that it's a job, and it's not. There's only certain times a year that you can dredge first. So, you know, you're going to metal detect half the year, dredge half the year, or work dry material, or hard rock mining, I guess, you know what I mean, you can do all year. But now you're dealing with explosives, working underground is much more dangerous. You need a processing plant, you need a ball mill, some kind of stamp, you know, ball mill. Then you need the permits to run acid, you know, recapture system. So yeah, there's no small, there's no middle area when it comes to gold mining. It's either recreational or lifestyle or a big business. I always suggest recreational, and if you do well, fantastic. You know what I mean? You had a great time. You can own mining claims for $100 a year that gives you 20 acres of land that you can go and spend the summer on and enjoy, you know what I mean? Improve the properties. It's a recreational thing. It's a lifestyle thing, okay? Don't, never think that you're going to, you know, listen, if you're 25 years old and you have no responsibilities and you can afford to go and dredge every day and have a travel trailer kind of thing, yeah, you can make a pretty good living. Now that gold is $2,000 an ounce, yeah, you can make a good living. Maybe it's going to go up, who knows, but yeah, you can. You can actually do okay. But even then, it's more about lifestyle. Unless you hit some, unless you get obscenely lucky, just like a lottery ticket or something, and find a big 900 ounce hole of nuggets, you know what I mean? Even if you got obscenely lucky, and it has happened, still, it's gambling. So it's about lifestyle. But again, if you're young, especially if you got, if you have a couple of people that are willing to work, and willing to camp out and rough it, you know what I mean? Not be afraid of packing in supplies, shit like that. There are places on the North Fork of the Feather River that can produce a half ounce a day, because I've seen it with people using buckets, snorkel gear, and a little aluminum sluice box that they had. They were very suspicious of us at first, but then everybody being so beat the fuck up from trying to move stuff down the wild and scenic, when we got there, they were growing pot. They warmed up real quick. But they were doing a half ounce a day with a bucket and, you know, a little army shovel and a fucking aluminum sluice box. They call it the wild and scenic for a reason, because people haven't been down there. So, you know, 90% of the plaster gold that was laying out there, even after all the gold rushes and all, is still laying out there for recovery. It's just sitting on the ground. People tend to walk up and have, find a rock that's exceptionally heavy, this big, and it turns out to be a solid piece of gold, that kind of thing. Gold's where you find it. It's kind of a bizarre thing, because I believe the Incas, the Mayas, I believe there were a lot of peoples that came and harvested the gold from the serpentine bedrock rivers of California when it was running smooth. The entire Sierra Nevadas, the rivers were running clean before we started interfering, screwing up the environment with giant, you know, monitors and pillaging. They just walked in and picked it up out of the cracks. So anyway, yeah, I see the fever. I understand it. I see what the, why they do what they do, why they live with the stress. Because unlike gold mining, no one's been here before. The Chinese never came 1,000 years ago and walked all the areas of Alaska finding jade. they actually do have a real opportunity here through hard work of finding something that's worth millions of dollars. So that's pretty cool. I'm in the second season, and I see their determination, and it's just like gold mining. They're roughing it in the middle of nowhere, and it's all so similar, you know what I mean, with everybody's fingers crossed, trying to get along, you know what I mean? Pretty cool, pretty cool. All right, so, yeah. You know, if you're young and you're healthy and you can afford it, fuck yeah, I'd go do it for 10 years. It's an incredible lifestyle, completely free, you know what I mean? And fun and healthy, you know what I mean? It's a lifestyle choice. There are not too many things you can do out there. I mean, I know people that do everything, like my mom and her friends. They did everything from mining, metal detecting, picking mushrooms, you name it. They did it. And they had a wonderful lifestyle. They were all very happy. Pretty hard to find that nowadays.